Greetings, I'm George Boston Rhymes. I want you to look, and I want you to compare information that takes place not only on the streets of Valdosta. I've been contending for the last 20, 25, 30 years that the news media, the Valdosta Daily Times, television stations, and radio stations seem to intentionally omit the news, omit newsworthy information. I want you to go to Boston GBR on YouTube. This video is on the streets of Valdosta called The Word on the Street, because a citizen has a right to know what is going on in their community. Last week, the SCLC president, Reverend Floyd Rose, called a press conference concerning the murder of Stephon Gotti in our community. Yet, what was published in the Valdosta Daily Times, in my most humble opinion, and others who have called me, is a disgrace, to say the least. And I want you to know that you can go to Boston GBR on YouTube and see this plus much, much more. Today I'm going to give you a short excerpt of what took place at this open meeting, press conference, if you will. Yet, little of the beef of what was said and done and called for were ignored. Just like the meeting that Councilman James Wright called at W.G. Nunn School. Redlining was ignored. Pastor Manning's outstanding words were ignored. The Democratic Party Chairman Gretchen were ignored. Pastor Risen was not mentioned. Nothing from the president of the NAACP, Lee Touchton, who is a national and international hero for being the first white woman to serve as president of a branch in the United States of America. Yet her words at the press conference were ignored. I'm going to give you a little lead into what you can get on YouTube, and then I'm going to walk you through and let you see what the Valdosta Daily Times and your local news media outlets fail to inform the people in this community. At Valdosta State University, you don't know nothing about this. Professors, this was kept away from you. Commanders and base and wing commanders at Moody Air Force Base, you don't know nothing about this took place in your community while you lived and your children attended school. This is not going to be a part of the archival record in the Valdosta Daily Times when those who come after us go back and look at the Times and think that they are getting the news when all they are getting is being used by those who don't want common everyday citizens to be informed. We can go to Iraq, Afghanistan, Vietnam, to Russia and fight for freedom of the press and freedom of speech in foreign nations while our own rights and freedom go to hell.
Martin Luther King Jr. had a friend that was labeled a communist, and they pushed him to not have anything to do with it. That was his friend. His friend hadn't did anything to him, and he wasn't aware of him doing anything equal to anybody else. So, by you trying to label folk or tell people who to talk to and who not to talk to, that's a lot of amendments that the Constitution had. And we ought to treat each other better. That's my point. And I'm pretty much finished with it.
All right. To the media, we decided not to answer any questions. That was Mr. Harris answering y'all's questions, so I respect y'all not to ask the media any questions as well. Just stick to your statement and be done with that. So we're not going to answer any questions because of fear of manipulation. So with that said, I'm going to introduce Ms. Olivia Pearson, City Commissioner.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. he said that you stated that had nothing to do with the group. Well, I'm not sure that you stated it didn't have anything to do with the group. I know just a minute ago, Jerry Hudson said it was mainly on Douglas Now, it was mainly about Bobby Worthy.
His article was?
Not quite. Supported by Commissioner Pearson. That's what he stated, which was a total lie because I had nothing to do with Bobby Worthy and Larry Neesmith. That was totally separable from this whole thing that you all have blown to hell, because that's what you've done.
Your name wasn't on that flyer for it, for the meeting, as a supporter?
Who held the meeting? You asked me a question. I'm asking you, who held the meeting?
I did, and you didn't answer it. Wasn't your name on that flyer?
I held the meeting. Sure, my name would be on it.
Okay,
well, see, that's where you went wrong.
That's all we said.
No. That's not all you said. That's not all you said. You said supported by Commissioner Pearson. What was supported by Commissioner Pearson?
The meeting.
The meeting that I called, that's exactly right. I called the meeting. Justice League did not call the meeting, first and foremost. They didn't call the meeting. I held a meeting through Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative for Economic and Social Justice. I invited Mr. Bobby Worthy and the NAACP. Let me finish, Mr. Hudson.
That was before the article, the mention of you.
No. You claim that the Justice League held this meeting, which was a lie. It was a lie. You said it, as well as the Douglas Enterprise said it. Justice League did not hold a meeting here in Douglas, Georgia. Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative held a meeting. I invited Mr. Worthy. I invited Ms. O'Hara as district rep for the NAACP. I invited Mr. Hal Presley. And matter of fact, I invited the entire community of the city of Douglas, Coffee County, Georgia. I announced it on my city council meeting. So why in the world, tell me, would I hold a meeting that's gonna succumb to or support hatred towards white people or any other people? Why would I hold a public announcement of a meeting like that? I haven't been in office for 15 years to do something so low down and dirty. See, you had your facts, you had your statements incorrect. Had you all given us the respect and decency to come and ask a question. Ed, you were at the meeting when I announced about that flyer. If you had a concern or an issue about it being to hate white folks or kill white folk, seemed like to me you would have had the courtesy, being that you were there, to have came to me, Commissioner Pearson, what is this about? But no, not one of you journalism fellas or lady, I'm not sure what part you played in it. So if you did play a part, excuse that comment. Not one of you had the decency or respect to come to me as an elected official and ask the question, what is this all about? A decent journalist who is seeking the truth has a moral and ethical obligation to go and get both sides of a story and not just print one side and not just assume. And none of you did that. So yes, I feel my life is threatened with something like this. And you sat there when Mr. Presley asked the question, have you gotten any feedback from anybody? Nobody would say anything. You didn't answer it. But I already know the answer to it. You've gotten feedback because I've gotten feedback. I've gotten feedback from white people. I've got feedback from black people. And they're not satisfied with it, black or white. And they have all said to me, Olivia, we know that's not true. So some people who might not know me might not know, but those who know me know I wouldn't take part in anything that's going to deal with hatred or killing or anything in breaking the law. So on now today, you all want to come and be a part of this press release, this news conference on today, after you have done your damage. Because like I said, damage has been done. Because don't everybody know all of us and what we stand for. It's just the grace of God that those who do know us No, we wouldn't dare partake of any such foolishness.
Amen.
And I feel like what you're doing is displaying what you have in your heart.
Amen.
To print something like this.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. I can say to you, not one of you have ever had me to say anything racist to you, to say anything about hatred to you, in dealing with your media and dealing with me. None of you can say that I've ever said anything racist.
Right.
If it's right, if it's a fact about what has happened, and it might tend to lean on one side of the color line or the other, call it what you may. But God be my judge. He knows my heart. And no, I wouldn't partake of anything such as this that you all have intended to influence this community to believe.
Amen. It's totally ridiculous. It's totally unacceptable. And
we are not going to tolerate it.
Mm-hmm.
So now you want to go and dig and talk about the use of the Coley Center. Get the records about the Coley Center. You dig on and see what you find. If anybody got any money for using the Coley Center, it definitely was not Commissioner Olivia Coley Pearson.
Right?
All right.
I have never used the Coley Center or any facility of the City of Douglas in an inappropriate manner. That's why I announced the meeting of that we were having on October 3rd. That's why I announced it at my City Council meeting. And I said then, anybody who is concerned about community and would like to help and take part, please come. That was my request. But you all are tending to try to divide this community more and more and more. I'm concerned as to who employs the Douglas Knight employees, as well as the Douglas Enterprise. What do these people stand for? I'm really surprised at this time. I'm surprised because your editors should have told you, go get the other side. See what they have to say about it before we print this.
Yes.
Should have been fact checked.
It should have been.
Should have been fact checked.
And it's sad. It's sad because it's too late in the day with too much everything that's going on in our surroundings and our communities and our different states. It's too much and too late in the day to try to print something like this to make white folk feel that they need to go and buy guns, which was announced at a church. Announced at church by a white lady that she needs to go and buy a gun because of this group that has been formed. And I suggest to the rest of y'all that y'all go buy one, is what she was quoted as saying. So if it's in y'all's heart to cause this kind of deliberate tension and division, you need to go check yourselves.
They damaged the community.
You need to go check yourselves. God is not pleased. God is not pleased. When I chose to run for office, I found all kind of opposition. Some by black folks, but some by white folks. And ever since I've been in office, I've had to deal with you all saying statements that were not true, trying to blemish my name. So whatever it is you're seeking, I hope you find it. But I can tell you, my name is not going to be blemished because the people know what I stand for. When I talk to the white city employees, Commissioner Pearson, we know you're not like that. But like I say, my concern is the people who do not know me.
Amen.
Who do not know me.
Amen.
Because my mother, an honorable woman, who I got emails and texts from people telling me when I expressed what was going on my Facebook page, they said, we know what your mother stood for. We know she didn't raise you that way.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm wondering, how have you all been raised?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I'm wondering today.
Right.
I'm wondering today. Because somebody from the media should have had the decency to see the true facts so justice would be known and would prevail.
That's right.
This plaque, since you all say recent altercation shines light on new militant organization. That's what y'all said. That's what y'all said. And I'm trying to find out where is this militant organization at. Because it's not us. It's not us. Some of us can barely walk. We are elderly, walking with sticks, but we are militant because we state what is the truth. We are seeking to make the community better, which is what I said at that city council meeting when I announced that meeting October 3rd. So how did militant organizations come out of it. It's wrong. The meeting I had, Southern Rural Black Women, has been here in Douglas Coffee County since 1999. And I was asked to chair and lead this group. Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative for Economic and Social Justice. Not just justice for black people or black women, but it's geared toward women. Because women have had a difficult time finding daycare, someone to keep their kids so they can go to work, trying to finish and get a GED so they can get a good job. That's why this group was formed and has received federal monies and money from private groups to help people who are a part of this to better their lives. And you would take the meeting we held, which was held, hosted by Southern Rural Black Women, and distort the facts. Shame on you.
Freedom go to hell. And what's so sad about it and sickening about it and disgraceful about it is that we, the Christian, Muslim, Jews, Hindu, and others, and atheists, sit back and just let people just shove it down our throat. Many Americans died for these rights, and yet we are watching them just vanish before our very eyes because we don't give a damn. I served my country for over 20 years, fighting for the rights and freedom of foreign people that I did not know, only to return home to be arrested to address my mayor and city council, just to be arrested because we just wanted something changed from a dirty history to bring up to the modern era, and 15 citizens were arrested. And those 15 people that were arrested, name was never published in the newspaper or put on TV. They were never said that they was following the dream of Dr. King or nothing. All they put those 15 people's name was in the crime report, but for the most part, they were ignored. And the next meeting following their arrest, they went right back to Valdosta City Council. And again, the South Georgia news media omitted what they said and did. And I have made it a part of the record. Now, we're not here for that today. I want you to go back to this man that was murdered at a local radio station, Magic 95, or 96.7 Hip Hop The Mix. And yet, this young man, his children, his family, his daughter spoke at the press conference, a school principal spoke, but I want you to listen. And then I want you to compare what you're gonna hear here to what was reported in your Valdosta Daily Times, radio, and television. Listen, please. I want you all to know the truth. You can find this on YouTube. I'm gonna excerpt, I'm not gonna repeat much of it because a lot of it is already on YouTube. I got the rest of the story, not only about this murder, but also about James Councilman Wright meeting that the time did a sorry job in keeping you informed. There was a 98-year-old educator that attended Fort Valley State College spoke to the young people at that meeting, yet nothing was said. Nothing was even mentioned about her. 97 or 98-year-old educator. It's a sad day in Valdosta, y'all. And we had better wake up. We had better wake up. This is my prelude into an hour video that I have on YouTube because I want you all to know, like Paul Harvey said, the rest of the story. So listen to my prelude, and we're going to get up and we're going to walk you through what our South Georgia news media apparently did not want you to know. And therefore, if you don't know nothing about all these people and all these compliments and all these things that took place, they will forever be locked out of history, much like the Quitman 10 case over there in Brooks County. Yeah, they don't want you to know, y'all. Y'all better wake up. Listen, please.
This is George Boston Rhymes, kvci.blogspot.com, Boston GBR on YouTube, doing what we do. We are on our way to a press conference called by Minister Floyd Rose, who is the president of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, SCLC, and we are going to meet President Lee Touchton there of the NAACP. We are also going to meet the NAACP president from the Valdosta State University chapter. And concerned citizens about a local death in the community, which we will not address right here. We want you to travel with us as we inform you on what is going on. I came because I'm concerned about what's going on in our community and the fact that much is happening in Valdosta and Lowndes County, Georgia, along with South Georgia in general. So much news that are not being reported. However, as I've been saying for several, at least two or three decades, that somewhere the 1860 charter mentality must cease.
This is as we travel to the news conference in here in Valdosta, because we want...
This is KBCI.blogspot.com, Boston GDR on YouTube. I'm down here with 96.7 from...
Nothing was said about this in your newspaper, television, or on radio. You're telling you why we were here. That was, we were letting the general public know why we came.
What's going on in the Gotti case. We want to know the status of the investigation in terms of what they have told Hilda, and this is why we're here on the scene. So we're going to be doing that today, because this is what we do to try to keep you informed. I was very happy to be...
This is... We went inside of the house of the mother because we wanted you to know. We didn't want you ignorant. We were talking about, we wanted to get with the sheriff. We wanted to know the status of the investigation. We wanted to know if white clubs were investigated, or was it just the black ones? That's the word that we receive in the civil rights organizations. These are valid questions that normally in an ideal American city where there's a valid newspaper and newspaper outlets and people that are conscious of the total community would won't explain to the general public. But you can see the rest of this on my YouTube channel, that's Boston GBR. Now here, we see that Reverend Rose also, along with, we want to thank ABC News, CBS, who was on the scene, and the Valdosta Daily Times reporter. But here again, much of this information were ignored in terms of who was there, who actually spoke. There, listen.
But I would like to read that statement on the air so people will know that it's not just a doctor that's concerned now.
They're going to go live with that.
I want you to know that, yes, they did. They went live here on Magic 95. They broadcast this live for the people in the community to know. And this is what it's all about, y'all.
And where is Jeremy, who's the president of the youth chapter?
NAACP youth chapter of Valdosta State University spoke. You don't know. What do you know about it? What did they tell you about him in terms of what he said? He called for Dr. Cole, a principal at Valdosta Middle School. There he is right there. See him? That's him. What did they say about him speaking at this new press conference? Now he's talking about Stefan's mother. He's reaching over and he's calling her to come up to the so she can speak if she so desired. And this is what took place at our meetings. But we must ask ourselves a question. Why would it be that, listen what Rose said.
Who was better known outside of the church area as Vaughn Gotti, was shot and killed. While he was on the phone, he identified his assailant as a white male. Since then,
he identified his assailant as a white male. And this is something that, in my most humble opinion, that it shouldn't take a little novice YouTube person to relay this information to the general public. But it seems like that's the case.
We don't think progress of any significance has been made.
All right. No significant progress have been made. The citizens in Lyons County and Valdosta need to know this. Don't you? Wouldn't you want to know that?
In the search for his assailant. And so today we've come again. We have promised this family on behalf of SCLC that we would not rest.
He made a promise that he would not rest. What do you know about that, Valdosta? Lyons County, the state of Georgia, and Al Sharpton and others around the nation? What do you know about this? Could you find it on the internet? Was it published? Or why was it hidden from you?
Until the assailant has been caught, tried, and convicted. I also said at the wake that unless there is community pressure, it is not likely that his assailant would be caught. I said that only because there is a tradition in the South that when a white man is suspected of killing a black man, the wheels of justice often turn extremely slowly and sometimes not at all.
Now, some people may disagree with him. Earl Evan was burned up in a police car in Quitman. You had 13 to 20 people that was murdered May the 18th, 17th, that whole week, called the Week of Terror around the world. Mary Turner was lynched. Sidney Johnson was dragged down South Patterson Street. Nobody's talking about that. As I said, the Wootons, the Denson was drowned in a pond. Nobody had been brought up on charges on none of these crimes against these murders. So what he's saying is not just words. These are real core cutting issues that need to be given to the people here in Valdosta, South Georgia. Willie James Williams died out there in the jail, and we're still searching for the murderer or the person that caused that death. And the family called me from time to time. And so this is nothing new here. There have been 30 other jail deaths. Valdosta and Lyons County leading the state of Georgia in jail deaths. Governor Nathan Deal will offer an executive order to have the Quitman 10 removed from the seats, but he and District Attorney David Miller and Assistant Brad Sheely has never asked for an investigation to see why Valdosta is leading the state of Georgia in jail deaths. But you don't know nothing about that because there's a pattern and practice that I contend that to keep the people ignorant. And it is becoming clearer and clearer that this is begin to resonate across the United States of America that this is indeed the case. It is also involving contracts, HUD. This thing is getting deep now. It's getting very deep. Listen, please. This Reverend Rose, but what did you hear about this in your newspaper and on your television station, or was it ignored?
And so we come today, once again, on behalf of this family, to demand that the killer of Stephon Edgerton be caught. Mrs. Hilda Edgerton, his wife, his children want the same thing. And now she's going to speak to the press, and she has some news.
Now, talked about the children.
It now, also she's going to speak to the press, and she has some news.
Now, say she has some news. What news do she have? What news does she have? Was anything quoted from the person who wrote whatever she may be presenting here? Let's listen and see. Let's listen and see. And then I want you to compare your daily Valdosta Daily Times, your television coverage of this news conference, and then I want you to look at Boston GBR on YouTube. That's Boston GBR. Then I want you to just look and see, did you get the rest of the story, or did you get something that was more reflective of the Valdosta 1860 charter that said the mayor and council shall pass all proper necessary laws and orders for the control of slaves and free persons of color and to control, suppress, and abate all nuisances arriving from hog, dogs, horses, or other livestock straying at large here in Valdosta. And now it seems like it's not only applicable to black folk, but now it seems like they want to keep all of us ignorant.
I just share a statement from the Reverend Jesse L. Jackson, Sr. Over the Rainbow Push Coalition.
Let's see what the civil rights leader has written to our community, our sheriff department, our members of law enforcement. Let's see what your newspaper told you about this and your television stations told you about this. It was all at the press conference. Hey, y'all, don't blame me. I didn't create all this. If I could create all this, I'm a genius. And I'm not. Listen.
This letter is a statement regarding the death of Stephan Edgerton, Chicago, May 24, 2012. Reverend Jesse L. Jackson and the Rainbow Push Coalition call upon Valdosta and Lowndes County officials to conduct...
What did Jesse Jackson call for? Do you know? Was it reported to you? What did this man who marched with Dr. King, Joseph Lowry, Tyrone Brooks, and many, many others, what does he want? What did he ask this area? Let's see.
A thorough and sifting investigation of all the facts and circumstances surrounding the untimely death of Mr. Stephan Juan Gotti Edgerton. We expect the district attorney and the local Lowndes County Sheriff's Department.
Now, he said the district attorney, that's David Miller. Now, they are asking this question, I believe, because the Honorable Judge Hugh Lawson ruled in June of 1997 that the Lowndes County Board of Commissioners correct the 105 violation out there in the Valdosta and Lowndes County Jail, at which time there was only 3 people that had died. Now it's 30. And I wrote District Attorney David Miller and Ms. Crow of the clerk of the court, and I also wrote the Honorable Judge Hugh Lawson, who failed to answer one question that I asked. And so I am of the impression that nobody ever followed up on Judge Hugh Lawson's order, and perhaps not even he himself. And so since that time, we have had people that die to the tune of 30, well, 27, because we had 3 at the time. But then from 1994 to 2009, we had approximately 30 deaths. And from 2009 to present, they won't even tell us how many people have died. The Valdosta Daily Times haven't requested it. The television stations haven't requested it. The radio stations haven't requested it. I have requested it, but they say they were not covered by the Georgia Open Records Act. That's what I got in writing. Of course, the Sheriff Prine came back at the Democratic headquarters meeting and told me that they were, and that he would notify me. But I still do not know, and you don't know either, but let's just skip along. I want you to get a picture, because I want you to know how ignorant the people here in this community, and we can't blame nobody but ourselves. We can't blame nobody for ourselves. A little place like America, Georgia, have 5 to 6 newspapers, and we only have 1. And that one seemed like, well, you listen.
To examine all of the clues, witnesses.
Yeah, this is what Jesse Jackson asked them, to examine all the clues, all the witnesses, because somebody's concerned. People know what's going on. Jesse Jackson have been notified way back with the Willie Jane Williams case. They all are familiar with this. Janice Mathers in Atlanta, Al Sharpton, everybody. And as Joseph Lowry said, that Valdosta, Brooks County, Lowndes County, and South Georgia in general would be, he said this in the 90s following Willie Jane, that this would be the new hub of the civil rights movement. And it seemed like our South Georgia news media is contributing to the fulfillment of Reverend Lowry's prophecy by not reporting the news.
Huh? You didn't look like killers to y'all?
No.
Look at me, I'm really scared. But before I address this, let me introduce myself. My name is Bobby Worthy. As y'all know, when you put it all over the paper, I have petitioned the court to change my name to Adil Mustafa Muhammad. Because I said in the media that I was going to get rid of my slave master name. Believe me, Bobby Worthy is not my ancestor's name. To clear that up. And yes, I did say that. But let me explain something to you. Let me give you a little history story that y'all manipulated this story for what happened to me and Larry Neesmith. Me and Larry Neesmith, and who is this, Ed in here? You're Ed? I sent you a copy of the emails that Larry sent me in July threatening me. So why would you say this has something to do with what happened to me and Larry Neesmith? What happened to me and Larry Neesmith started in July because, let me explain to you, because his pastor we discovered in Homerville, Georgia, was signing illegal bonds. That's how it started with me and Larry Neesmith. Because he said his pastor is a good pastor. But that's not what the Georgia Secretary of State is saying right now. He was signing legal bonds even in Coffee County. And he didn't have the assets to back him up. That's what started with me and Larry Neesmith. When he said, on my Facebook page, said, Bobby Worthy, I'm the wrong one. I'll come see you. So I said, come see me. That was in July. And you try to justify him and my past? Justify him attacking me at the old time restaurant? You better be glad you have bond here instead of him. Because the Georgia Castle Doctrine Law gives me that right to protect myself, deadly if necessary. Now let's get it, don't get it twisted and keep it real. He attacked me, and y'all trying to justify him committing a crime? Really? And y'all call yourself journalists? Understand that. So if you want to know the whole history of me and Larry Neesmith, go to my page, Bobby Worthy. I posted everything that he sent me on Facebook back in July. So you'll know how it started with Larry Neesmith. It did not start with this meeting. A matter of fact, Larry Neesmith called her and told her, you better not mess with Bobby Worthy, he trouble. So who was the trouble one? Who attacked me in public? And see, that's what y'all don't know. And I understand the media, you're trying to sell a story. But I sent you that, and you should have printed that, where it started. But yet, you say, new militia group, new recent altercation shines light on militia group. It had nothing to do with this group.
Nothing.
Nothing. Nothing at all. It was Larry V. Smith's ego. They got his ass locked up, excuse my language, but ass in the Bible. Now I'm gonna break down this article for y'all. All right, y'all said in here, you got me standing on the flag. And what you got these people standing on the flag. Please believe me, all the stuff that you go on my page, if you read the whole thing, you'll see the Lord justified. So just like you'll put the flag, the reason I put the thing on the flag, about the flag in there, is because there is no law for you to burn or desecrate the flag. There is no law against that. The Supreme Court has ruled that, and you printed part of that, you should have went in there and read the whole law. It's in there. I didn't rule it. The U.S. Supreme Court ruled it. Now, it's not ethical for us veterans to step on the flag and all that, but I just let that know because people, the case in Valdosta, people were so wildly about this guy walking on the flag. So what is wrong with informing the people of the truth? Of their rights, their legal rights. And then you're gonna bring up my past. Something happened 30 years ago. Please, I moved on. Y'all suggest y'all do the damn same. Now y'all call me militant? Yeah, I say some things people don't like. And you say, but then you talk about me on here. You talk about against white people? Really? My mama's white. Now don't y'all feel ignorant. Now, don't y'all feel ignorant. You know, like I said, now Jerry Hudson, now he printed the stuff about me, but what he did when he added Miss Olivia to it, then that's fine. I don't care if he printed what he printed about me, but I'm pretty sure he got what I printed back. Understand, racism, a form of racism, racism in this country would not exist if it wasn't for people like you manipulating it. Now, y'all can say what you want to say. You know what I'm saying? You can take a black baby, a white baby, a Jew baby, you put them in a box and they'll play, they see your cup.
Yes.
Racism is taught at the house.
Yes.
It is not nothing you're born with.
Right. Amen.
That was
right. It's tight, but it's right.
Mm-hmm. Come on in, little man.
Come on.
I toned it down since the children in here.
Yeah, this is what Jesse Jackson asked him to examine all the clues, all the witnesses, because somebody's concerned. People know what's going on. Jesse Jackson have been notified way back with the Willie Jane Williams case. They all are familiar with this. Janice Mathers in Atlanta, Al Sharpton, everybody. And as Joseph Lowry said, that Valdosta, Brooks County, Lyons County, and South Georgia in general would be, he said this in the 90s following Willie Jane, that this would be the new hub of the civil rights movement. And it seemed like our South Georgia news media is contributing to the fulfillment of Reverend Lowry's prophecy by not reporting the news. But it is being saved, archived, because we want generations to know what apparently others do not want you to know. Y'all excuse me, let's get back.
Other relevant evidence to assure that justice is served. Mr. Edgerton was a husband and a father whose family is entitled to answers, to closure, and to simple justice. all life is precious and deserves to be protected.
What did you hear about this in your paper? What did you see about this on TV? What did you hear about this being discussed on talk radio by Tom Joyner, Michael Bazin, and others? Well, if they don't know because it's not reported, they're going to be like you are, ignorant.
Reverend Jesse L. Jackson, singer.
Well, that's the wife, the children standing there, but somebody don't care enough about keeping us informed, in my most humble opinion, as they should. Let's go a little further. Let's see if we can see something else that just maybe was not reported to you. Okay? Now, this lady about to come up, she is a historic figure. But why would somebody ignore the president of the local NAACP, not mention a one word that she was even at the press conference? What's happening to America? Our sons and daughters are on foreign battlefields, fighting for the rights of others, for freedom of the press and freedom of speech. Listen at the president, Lee Turchin of the NAACP. What does she have to say about this?
I'm Lee Turchin, president of the Valdosta Lounge NAACP branch. The NAACP is responsible for ensuring equality for all citizens, and that means that whenever a citizen is killed in a suspicious manner, that we expect the police department and the sheriff's department to conduct a thorough investigation.
What's wrong with letting the people know that?
Dr. David Cole.
Now, this is David Cole. Let me back up, y'all. I got to go back to this. I can't leave Lee Turchin. She is so often ignored until I'm going to do a repeat on her. I'm not going to interrupt this.
I'm Lee Turchin, president of the Valdosta Lounge NAACP branch. The NAACP is responsible for ensuring equality for all citizens, and that means that whenever a citizen is killed in a suspicious manner, that we expect the police department and the sheriff's department to conduct a thorough investigation. We expect that all leads will be looked into, and we expect people in the community to come forward. There is a reward for information about the murder of Juan Gotti. We know that we're looking for a white man. We know that there are pieces of evidence that fit into a puzzle that just hasn't been put together yet, and we're asking you to come forward and to help this family. And I'm asking the sheriff's department, who's given me personal assurances that they are doing everything they can, I am asking that he reassure this family and reassure this community that he takes this as seriously as we do. The NAACP stands in solidarity with this family. Thank you.
Now, what was wrong? Why would somebody not want you to know what this historic figure said? It's like James Councilman Wright meeting, wherein the beef of that meeting went ignored. Redlining, tidal ponds, all these things that are problems and impediments in our community, and the men failed to mention that in-depth HUD reporting that I traveled up to the federal building in Atlanta, Georgia, and talked with Mr. Investigators and Mr. Clark and Ms. Taylor and others. And then 2 weeks later, John Robertson journeyed up to ask about the impediment study and of analysis and how dollars were being diverted to the north side and the south side were being likened. And you're going to hear a lot more about that. But it seemed like the preachers and the professional people are, let's listen to another person here who got something to say that was omitted, possibly.
Co-workers at
V96.7. What was mentioned in your paper about his co-workers in terms of how he viewed Mr. Stefan? Well, you can only figure why. It seemed like the 1860 Charter to Control, Suppress, and Abate is alive and well. In Valdosta, Georgia, home of Moody Air Force Base, Valdosta State University, Wild Adventures Theme Park, Georgia Military College, Wiregrass Technical College. Seems strange, don't you?
And right now we're appealing to the community, to everyone. You heard what members here have said today. We need answers. We need you to come forth with information. We need information, and we are just praying for this family, and we also want to lift them up in this time. Right now we want to definitely keep searching and try to find out what we can about this just horrific murder. And we definitely need answers. We need you to contact the local authorities, call the radio station. Whatever you have to do, we need you. We need people to really come forth with information at this time.
Well, yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
My name is Jeremy Henry, spokesperson for the Lounge Valdosta Youth NAACP.
Here we go again. What was said? Why wouldn't anybody not want the citizens to know that we have young black men who are in the NAACP and who's in college and who are trying to better themselves as well as take on the issues of their neighbors and their citizens? Why would anybody not want people to know that in a metro city? Why would anybody not want this given to the general public?
As our president stated earlier, we are standing behind the Edgerton family 100% until justice is served to our community and to this beautiful family. We plan as the youth of this community to rally together, to stand behind this family, to investigate, interrogate, and aggravate the Lowndes County Department and this community. So we stand with the Edgerton family, and we ask you all, if you have any information, please come forward and let us bring justice to this case.
Once again, why would they not want this published to the general public? Why would they not want this published? What say you?
This one here especially, it really got me, but you know. But like I said, let me explain something to y'all. Y'all can print what you want about me. I love it. This is my house. Understand? This is my crack cocaine for you to talk about me. Understand that? This is my crack cocaine for you to wake up in the morning and think about Bobby Worthy. Understand? Because I'm going to do what I need to do, no matter what none of y'all say. And yes, I got on my page, I told them that the law says this. I didn't rule this. The U.S. Supreme Court ruled this. The U.S. Supreme Court said I have a right to resist any false arrest with just as much violence as they have to make it deadly if necessary. The Supreme Court ruled that. I didn't. I just put it on my page and y'all manipulated it.
See that?
Read the law. Everything on my page is within bounds of the law. I am the only activist that has unseated a judge. Understand that? And Doug, I'm going to be real. Douglas Enterprise, get ready. Understand that? Those stiffness lawsuits you talked about, guess what? You'll be one of them. I promise you. I promise you. Because my knees is only by the Jesus. Understand that? My knees only by the Jesus. And then what are you with? And like I said, if anybody feels they don't like what I say, oh well, God bless you anyway, but I'm going to do what I need to do. No disrespect to y'all and who y'all is, but I'm just setting y'all straight. Because you, the way you manipulated this paper is a disgrace to the media. Is it a disgrace? Especially when I sent you where it started at. I sent you the paperwork where it started at, and then you come back and print this. This meeting started, that's how the altercation started with Larry Neesmith. That's not how the altercation started with Larry Neesmith at all. So y'all know the truth. So what I would hope you do is go and print the truth. Just all we ask is you print the truth. Print whatever you want. But we ask you to print the truth. That's all. You know, and I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna be honest with you. My take on this was to throw y'all out. That's my militant ways, understand that? That was my take, but there everybody voted not to. Understand that? That's my militant way, and that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna stand for justice. I go against black folks just like I do white folks. How can you Oh, I really, how can you, if you went through my page, you'll see I go out and to address your issues, I meant to say this, the bootlicking Negro, the Uncle Tom, the Chicken George. Yes, that's a term that black folks use. When we got these people, the infiltrators and the cowards and the coons running behind closed doors, snitching and kissing butt with the enemy. And I'm not saying y'all my enemy, right. But if you're against justice and for injustice, yes, you're my damn enemy.
That's right. That's right. It's about justice.
It's about justice and what's right. I don't care what color you is.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
So let's not get that twisted and make sure you print my mama's white. Really? Since I'm a racist, and first of all, y'all don't know the definition of racism. In order to be a racist, you have to have money and power to affect change in an ethnic group. How many black folks got that?
No.
We can be prejudiced, but we cannot be racist.
All right.
Now, y'all want us, the white people want us to remember the Holocaust. Oh, they want us to remember Vietnam. They want us to be World War I, World War II. They want us to remember 9/11. But you want us to forget 400 years of oppression, murder, and innocent people. We need to move, West sir, you need to move on. How dare you? No, you need to move on from 9/11 because your own government did it. Mm-hmm. Now, that's how I stand. That's how real I am, 100% all the time. Like I said, the only thing y'all can do is bring up my past. Oh, Mr. Worthy got the past. Oh, his picture, look at him. Oh, he was so him. You know what? Y'all got me 500 more friends on Facebook because of that. I appreciate it. And one lady said, oh, God, you're such a handsome young man. Appreciate it. Thank you, dog. I really appreciate it. Print it on. But believe me, print what you must. But please, dear, if you can handle what comes back at you. Because guess what? I go toe-to-toe with the devil if I have to. Understand? I don't bow nobody. My knees, again, like I said, only bow to Jesus, and then one of you him.
Right. I like that. Right.
So I fear no man. You can ask anybody about Bobby Worthy, and they'll tell you all they can. The one thing they'll tell you, Bobby Worthy ain't no coward.
Hello.
Understand that. And I hate to say this, but your former candidate for state representative found out that I wasn't a coward. And I'm just going to get it straight. And I'm going to prosecute him to the fullest of the law. I hate to do it because he's black, but it seems like I got to show y'all people. Better than I can tell you. In the city commission, I watched the tape. Three of your city commissioners, gave him condolences for committing a crime attacking me. Really? And like y'all said, three bootlickers. And I tell them to their face, understand that. I don't scare about nobody. Understand that. I just wanted y'all to get that clear. You know, I can be the nicest guy in the world. I can be the haters one in them. Like I said, if y'all were to print something just about me, y'all never heard a word from me. Because I get it all the time. I've been to Charleston, South Carolina, Baltimore, as y'all said, all over the country. Yes, I go all over the country to attack injustice. I left Baltimore, Manual 9, where y'all misquoted me talking about Denmark Vesey. That I discussed about Denmark Vesey. Who in here know who Denmark Vesey is? Do y'all? You Denmark Vesey? Denmark Vesey was the co-founder of Emmanuel A&M Church that was the Emmanuel 9 was killed in. And because Denmark Vesey's plan was to kill all slave masters. And because of the bootlicking, Uncle Tom's, Chicken George, coons and cowards running behind the corner, they snitched on him and 30 other people were tried that day, hung, and throw it in the Bay Area for shark bait. And you ask us to forgive 400 years? Really? Some of you, and I can say that here too, because you know we got some mixture in us too, I do, and I might have some on my side. Some of you are direct descendants of murderers, killers, rapists, and killers and murders of babies of innocent people because of their skin. Did you think 400 years of oppression that we can just forget?
Nope.
We can just, and if we're still going through, we are still in a mental state of slavery.
Mm-hmm.
And we are still in a mental state of slavery.
Yeah.
Now, we just left the Million Man March. Honorable Louis Minister Farrakhan, y'all give him a hand. witnesses if you have to. We as black folks spend $7 trillion a year in this country, and we get no respect. But everybody, you want to talk about what I talk about, but let's talk about the police officers just killed a man in Savannah, Georgia, and tased them in the nuts. Where's that all in the media? Tied to a chair. He tied to a chair. He was tied to a chair. Why ain't y'all all over that printing that? And they see the taser tasing the man in the nuts. Yeah. Killing innocent unarmed black men, and it's getting to be comfortable. Mm-hmm. And he's not even just black men, but lower class whites as well. Mm-hmm. That's what they call trailer park trash. So let's not get it twisted. It's just the cause of what we go through because of more and more blacks are being targeted and harassed by black folks. It's the reason we feel like this. You know what I'm saying? So they always talking about why black lives matter. This is a good one. The media goes, sir, don't all lives matter? I said, well, ma'am, you know something? Yes, they do. All lives do matter. Right. But we're concentrating on the black ones right now because you people and the government seems to think it doesn't matter. And when you can show me that whites are targeted, harassed, and beaten and killed just as much as blacks, then until then, it's black lives matter. All right. And with that said, I'm not gonna make this a long media.
Ain't none of this been in the paper on there. White commissioner, whatever they said, whatever.
None of
it. Time you turn around, Commissioner Pearson, Commissioner Pearson, Commissioner Pearson. Commissioner Pearson is tired.
And with that said, I want you to tell me, y'all need to start attending your meetings. Y'all need to start getting involved in your communities. Your children, your mothers, and you need to start getting involved with these meetings they have so you can know how to combat and fight this injustice against our color, our people. You need to start getting involved in community fairs, community events, and all that. Matter if they're black or white, get involved. Come to your city commission, the school board meetings, and all that there. You got young girls at the schoolhouse now, 12 and 13 year old, holding hand, kissing. Really? That's because our government has lost their mind.
Now that is a disgrace on our government. And I'm gonna say it again. We had better wake up and understand that Jim Crow is at your back door, and it's time for you to get up into the realities of what's going on with all these elected black mayors and other black elected officials. Go to Douglas, Georgia. I didn't mention Douglas, Georgia. The commissioner in Douglas, Georgia. Look and see what the Douglas Enterprise, see what they did to her. And I guess the worst is yet to come. But in the end, truth, right, and justice will win beyond question. And if truth, justice, and right does not win, then God himself is a liar. This is the Ghetto Free Press. Bye-bye. God.
rest. Bye-bye. Go.
So why in the world tell me would I
hold a meeting that's going to succumb to or support hatred towards white people or any other people, why would I hold a public announcement of a meeting like that? I haven't been in office for 15 years to do something so low down and dirty. See, you had your facts, you had your statements incorrect. Had you all given us the respect and decency to come and ask a question, Luke, you were, not Luke, Ed, you were at the meeting when I announced about that flyer. If you have a concern or issue about it being to hate white folks or kill white folks, seemed like to me you would have had the courtesy, being that you were there, to have came to me, Commissioner Pearson, what is this about? But no, not one of you, not one of you journalism fellas or lady, I'm not sure what part you played in it, so if you did play a part, excuse that comment. Not one of you had the decency or respect to come to me as an elected official and ask the question, what is this all about? A decent journalist who is seeking the truth has a moral and ethical obligation to go and get both sides of a story and not just print one side and not just assume. And none of you did that. So yes, I feel my life is threatened with something like this. And you sat there when Mr. Presley asked the question, have you gotten any feedback from anybody? Nobody would say anything. You didn't answer it. But I already know the answer to it. You've gotten feedback. Because I've gotten feedback. I've gotten feedback from white people. I've got feedback from black people. And they're not satisfied with it, black or white. And they have all said to me, Olivia, we know that's not true. So some people who might not know me might not know, but those who know me know I wouldn't take part in anything that's going to deal with hatred or killing or anything in breaking the law. So on now today, you all want to come and be a part of this press release, this news conference on today, after you have done your damage. Because like I say, damage has been done. Because don't everybody know all of us and what we stand for. It's just the grace of God that those who do know us know we wouldn't dare partake of any such foolishness.
Amen.
And I feel like what you're doing is displaying what you have in your heart.
Amen.
To print something like this.
Amen.
Yes. I can say to you, not one of you have ever had me to say anything racist to you, to say anything about hatred to you, in dealing with your media and dealing with me. None of you can say that I've ever said anything racist. If it's right, if it's a fact about what has happened, and it might tend to lean on one side of the color line or the other, call it what you may. But God be my judge. He knows my heart. And no, I wouldn't partake of anything such as this that you all have intended to influence this community to believe.
Amen.
That's
And we are not going to tolerate it.
Mm-hmm.
So now you want to go and dig and talk about the use of the Coley Center.
Mm.
Get the records about the Coley Center. You dig on and see what you find. If anybody got any money for using the Coley Center, it definitely was not Commissioner Olivia Coley Pearson.
Right?
All right.
I have never used the Coley Center or any facility of the City of Douglas in an inappropriate manner. That's why I announced the meeting of that we were having on October 3rd. That's why I announced it at my City Council meeting. And I said then, anybody who is concerned about the community and would like to help and take part, please come. That was my request. But you all are tending to try to divide this community more and more and more. I'm concerned as to who employs the Douglas 9 employees as well as the Douglas Enterprise. What do these people stand for? I'm really surprised at this time. I'm surprised because your editor should have told you, go get the other side. see what they have to say about it before we print this.
Should have been fact checked.
It should have been.
Should have been fact checked.
And it's sad. It's sad because it's too late in the day with too much everything that's going on in our surroundings and our communities and our different states. It's too much and too late in the day to try to print something like this to make white folk feel that they need to go and buy guns, which was announced at a church. Announced at church by a white lady that she needs to go and buy a gun because of this group that has been formed. And I suggest to the rest of y'all that y'all go buy one, is what she was quoted as saying. So if it's in y'all's heart to cause this kind of deliberate tension and division, you need to go check yourselves.
They damage the community.
You need to go check yourselves. God is not pleased. God is not pleased. When I chose to run for office, I found all kind of opposition. Some by black folks, but some by white folks. And ever since I've been in office, I've had to deal with you all saying statements that were not true, trying to blemish my name. So whatever it is you're seeking, I hope you find it. But I can tell you, my name is not going to be blemished because the people know what I stand for. When I talk to the white city employees, Commissioner Pearson, we know you're not like that. But like I say, my concern is the people who do not know me. Who do not know me.
Amen.
Because my mother, an honorable woman, who I got emails and texts from people telling me when I expressed what was going on my Facebook page, they said, we know what your mother stood for. We know she didn't raise you that way. But I'm wondering, how have you all been raised? Yes, I'm wondering today. I'm wondering today. Because somebody from the media should have had the decency to see the true facts, so justice would be known and would prevail.
That's right.
This plaque, since you all say recent altercation shines light on new militant organization, that's what y'all said. That's what y'all said. I'm trying to find out, where is this militant organization at? Because it's not us. It's not us. Some of us can barely walk. We are elderly, walking with sticks. But we are militant because we state what is the truth. We're seeking to make the community better, which is what I said at that city council meeting when I announced that meeting on October 3rd. So how did militant organizations come out of it? It's wrong. The meeting I had, Southern Rural Black Women, has been here in Douglas Coffee County since 1999. And I was asked to chair and lead this group. Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative for Economic and Social Justice. Not just justice for black people or black women, but it's geared toward women, because women have had a difficult time finding daycare, someone to keep their kids so they can go to work, trying to finish and get a GED so they can get a good job. That's why this group was formed and has received federal monies and monies from private groups to help people who are a part of this to better their lives. And you would take the meeting we held, which was hosted by Southern Rural Black Women, and distort the facts. Shame on you.